Hello everyone, my name is Frosty the Cube and today I am here to bring you a tutorial on Elite Dangerous on how to make money. So I'm gonna get you from 1,000, not really, you need to have like 100,000 at least to start with, so you have pretty decent ship, pretty transport ship like an asp is I think 6 million, so yeah, it would be get your first 6 million and stuff like that. Upgrade your ship as you go, do some mission, maybe some bounty hunting, and then you can do what I'm doing right now. So I am in a Python and I'm right now at Robigo Mines. This is a very good place to get money from smuggling different items and anything they give you. Pretty much you're getting missions for about 6 million credits, okay, which is a lot. So I'm gonna get you from, let's say, 10 million to about, hold on, there we go, to about 251 million. Well, not really, you can, if you continuously do this, yes, you will get pretty high. As you can see, I'm an entrepreneur as a trade rank and I'm about to become, I think, I can't remember what was the next one. So yeah, there's been an update. Robigo Mines is not the same. There's been that engineer update and it kind of changed the way Robigo Mines works, but it's still kind of the same. So as we're just waiting for the missions to show up, there we go. So normally I'm just gonna get my missions from the CD Corporation. That's pretty much where I get my missions, and honestly I don't get those higher ones for 7 mil. I know they look big and stuff, like, oh my god, 7 mil, holy shit. No, don't do that. I would recommend you to start with like 24 units so you have more space. There's no need to get all the missions because you can just, like this one, 16 units and you get 6 million just for carrying them. By the way, you need a ship with pretty decent fuel tank and you need a fairly good fuel scoop because you need to do a lot of jumps. You need to travel like 772 light years just to do this mission. So yeah, I'll get this one, I think, and I'll get the one with 16. That's a must have. And look, some of them are in the same place, like the one I got and this one are in the same location, but I think they are in different stations. I mean, that's okay, you can't have everything. Right, so I'm getting this one and this one. Right, now you would think, oh, I'm good to go. If you're me, not really, because I have a lot more space than just 72. So I have 188 space, and I want to use that space. I want to make as much money as possible. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to press ESC. Here we go, ESC. I'm going to just log out like so. And now I'm going to go, sorry. Now I'm going to go on start, and instead of open play, you have to be in a different different server, for example, a private group or a solo campaign, solo play or whatever. So I was in open play, now I'm going in a private group. By the way, I was messing around with my name. First time I got the game, I didn't... Alright, you know what? Leave my name alone. So, now that I logged out, there should be new missions. Here we go, let's mission board, and I should be getting new missions. You can also just quit desktop. There we go. So I have new missions right here. Right. Sometimes you just have desperate moments where you can't just log out. If you close the game and you open it back, it won't give you money. It won't give you different missions, sorry. So I'll take this one for 12. That's very useful. 12, it's really not that much. I mean, if you have an asp, that could hold like 80 cargo. So there you go. You could make what 12 times? I think 12 times. I would say 7, which gives you 84. Yeah, 12 times 7 gives you 84. You can make decent amount of money. Wait, hold on. Yeah, I'm right. I'm a good mathematician. I'm shit, by the way. So yeah, if you have 84 cargo, there you go. You can get like what? 6 times 7, that would be fuck. Maths, please. 42 million. There you go. 42 million in one run. And I mean, that's a lot for you starting right now. That's a lot for 42 million. Just add another 42 million. You could buy a Python, depending on what system you're in and where you're buying it from. You can get a Python 25% off, which I don't know. I mean, just search it up on Google. It's probably going to show some good stations that sell Pythons. And yeah, so that's what you need to do. Just get those missions, 6 million. And if you didn't, if you haven't smuggled yet, if it's your first time doing it, I would recommend to not use shields. Sorry. Yeah, don't use, I would recommend to not use shields. Okay, if you're a beginner, I would recommend not to use shields. It attracts more pirates, depending either police. They can see you easier, so it's better without shields, and you get space for cargo. Like I did, I have 188. I should have a lot more, I think, if I had a worse fuel scoop. Yeah, I could put it up to a higher quantity, but I would rather stay with fuel scoop so I don't have to wait too much when I'm doing the missions. Right, so I'm gonna do this a couple more times and I will be back. Right, now that I'm done with all this, I think I have approximately, yeah, nearly a full cargo. So you would say, oh, but you can still put 12 in. Yes, but getting 12 and 6 million as a reward, it's really hard and sometimes can be even rare. So, yeah. So my inventory is, I think, full of slaves, if I'm right. Yep, there we go. And right now, my bad, I could make 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 7, so 7 times 6, 42 million. Hold on, no, not 42, 6 times 36 million. So this run just give me 36 million. And with that, I can buy some lightweight alloys. I can buy heavy duty alloys, I think. I can buy good stuff. And all right, if you're new to the game, you probably might not have this amount of reputation. You need repetition, as you can see here. I need to be a cardinal, and I really don't know how to get cardinal, and I'll try to find out. Maybe it's a much easier way, but it looks, as you can see, the pay is pretty bad. So a CD cardinal is, I think, empire. So yes, you have to have a good reputation with empire, and you have to do missions. So she would come up, I think, when you're in an empire place, you know, empire like gender. I'm in gender right now. Well, right now I'm in Rugby Go, but that's my place I normally stay. So yeah, if you're in gender, she will come up to your missions. You can do missions for her or him. I think sometimes it changes the picture. I don't know. And your reputation will just increase. I have full reputation with, so current state investment, I'm allied, there you go. So all right, one more thing. Yes, if you So if you don't have this type of reputation, what you can do after, just hold on after I do this route, after I do this real quick, all those missions, and I'll get on with how you can, if you don't want to do smuggling either, you like there's I think two more systems pretty far away that don't do smuggling. They do transporting, so it's not illegal, it's legal, and if you get scanned there will be no penalty. Right, so you can, as you can remember in the old times, if you had smuggling missions, if you were to be get if you were to be scanned, well, that's it, bye bye, no more mission, GG, end the game. Right now it's just a bonus, so if I get scanned, instead of 6 mil I'll get 4 mil, right? Every mission will give me 4 mil instead of 6. Okay, so let's start the launch. And I guess let's just plot the routes. Should be, hold on galaxy map. All right. So,
Ship released. Engine engaged.
when you,
Hull
fucking
integrity
hell. All
compromised.
right, so when you're done with all these missions, when you have them in your transactions, this will show up on the galaxy map. This red circle here with, I don't know, it's like a planet or something. This shows you where your mission is. So this is the system you have to go to, and looks like, yeah, those are all the systems. Right, so I want to go to the nearest one, so it's much easier for me to start with. I guess I'll have to, normally I like to just plot a route. For example, like I would go here, then here, and here, and go back. But right, I'll start from here instead. Okay, so plot the route. Remember, fastest route. You just click here and you click on this. You click on this, yeah, and it will put the faster route. It will recalculate your route and it will be the fastest one. And there you go. So you might, with an ASP, you might have a higher jump range than I do. I have 22 light years, I think, without, yes. So without any, hold on, what? Anyway, so apparently without any cargo, I have 19.96 light years. With full cargo, I have 15.30 light years. Right now I have 72 cargo, so there we go. And 15.61 light years. That would be, I think, about 30 jumps. Yeah. 28. Okay, 28 jumps. Close enough. So yeah, just take off your landing gear and boost. Charge your frameshift drive. And you're off. And you're off into the into adventure. Right, so here's the problem. If you don't have a big enough tank of fuel, you could technically run out of fuel, because there will be about 7 jumps or four jumps. I don't know. 4 jumps from now, depending on how many light years your frameshift drive can jump. There will be a line of brown dwarfs. and you can't refill on those. So I recommend about every four jumps refill, like I'm doing right now. So there you go, a good fuel scoop is just gonna benefit you. So slowly, and we're done. Off to the other side. Right, so I think we're gonna start hitting the brown dwarfs, because this is, I think, a white dwarf from its looks and its size. Just got past it real quick. And this, I think, if I'm right, that would be nice. Oh, okay, so here's an interdiction. You either... Alright, so what you wanna do? It's either stop, throttle to zero, and then... put all your power in engines and instantly boost away. So just keep pressing the boost button with power on all your engines, and he would, I don't think he will be able to catch up with you. So yeah, that's a good trick that you need to know in case of an interdiction, probably by the police, maybe by a pirate. Okay, so there we go, I'm still boosting away. Waiting to charge my frameshift drive, and then I can continue my journey. There we go. No harm has been done to my ship. Okay, so I was right with the brown dwarf. So this should start a big line, about seven systems. Pardon me. Seven systems in a line full of brown dwarfs. Because this is cool sector. Normally, when sectors show up as names, you probably should be careful. It's either a brown dwarf, or it could just be a normal planet. A normal planet? What the fuck? Normal star. One thing I'll recommend if your destination is... okay. So, let's say your destination is a little bit further from here, okay? And you have a teeny tiny bit of fuel. What I would do, go on your panels, galaxy map, and... where is it? Go to, I think, map here. And you can just click off all of those stars, okay? So pause the video if you wanna, I don't know, write it down, take a screenshot, whatever. So all of those stars, the rest of those stars, I think this one as well, they are scoopable stars. Okay, so here we go, another interdiction. As I said, stop the boost, stop moving, stop thrusted down, and just boost away. Max power on engines, boost away till your frameshift drive is done with the cooldown. There we go. Now boost away. Right, so my target is William Dock, which is not that far. Ah, fuck, he's catching up with me. What? This guy doesn't give up, does he? Jesus Christ. Oh my god, he's annoying. This one is one of the worst pirates you can possibly encounter. Okay, so go inside the orbit so you will be facing the station. Come on, just get there. Come on. Okay. There we go. Wow, that was so close. Okay. So, right now, just boost where you think the front of the station is. That's what I'm doing right now. Just judging where it could be. I'm just approaching it. Slowly approaching it. Right. I'm gonna request docking, and this is the hardest part. You need to boost in without damaging your ship, so you won't get scanned. Okay, just a little practice with. If sometimes you will fail. Wow, what a journey we're in. Oh my god. And with what health? Jesus. This can sometimes happen. What? Whoa! What? You fucking kidding me? Guys, I'm gonna stop here. This doesn't make sense. The bot is not supposed to follow you that far. What the fuck happened? I'm making a tutorial here. What is going on? Elite, please fix this. So yeah, I guess, well, if you guys, if you find this helpful, if it worked out for you guys, hopefully it did, hopefully you didn't get a stupid bot that chases you inside the station just to kill you. He's not gonna get anything out of it because the police is gonna shoot him instantly. Wow. That's pissing me off. How is he? Oh my god. This is very rare. This never happened to me, so trust me on this. About the transportation one, I kind of ran out of time, so if we hit 50 likes on this video, I will do the transportation one where people that don't have high reputation with Empire can get a decent amount of money out of transporting stuff. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like if you want me to make the other one. Subscribe to see my latest content. If you want to turn off notifications, that would be great. You'll be notified when I upload any of my content daily. So yeah, that's all from me. Thanks for watching.